The Figure 02 is generating serious buzz for its 150 Newton meters of torque. What does that compare to? First, let's preview what's to come. Stick around for the latest in humanoid robotics, including details about Figure's pilot at BMW, UBTECH's pint-sized humanoids working around the clock at a Chinese EV maker, a German cognitive robot, China's big leap in robot facial expressions, a robotic drink server inside Walmart, and growing calls to ban China's AI robots in the US, plus a throwback robot and other developments you might have missed. Subscribe to stay up to date with the latest in humanoid robots as the market evolves rapidly. The Figure 02's 150 Newton meters of torque is about the amount of force needed to tighten a medium-sized bolt with a standard wrench. It's also similar to the torque a compact car's engine makes when it accelerates from a stop. With this amount of torque, the Figure 02 can handle tasks that require significant force like lifting or rotating heavy objects. Figure AI calls the Figure 02 the most advanced humanoid robot on the planet and the first commercially viable autonomous humanoid robot. The Figure 02 has 3 times more computing power than its predecessor, the Figure 01. CNET notes the robot's wires are hidden, implying that Figure is moving past the prototype stage where easy access to parts is needed for fixes and adjustments. Its foot design is more human-like, suitable for sneaker fitting. The 5'6" Figure 02 has 6 cameras to see and understand its surroundings. It talks to people using built-in microphones and speakers. Its human-like hands can carry up to 55 pounds. The battery runs for 5 hours, a 50% improvement. The robot, also noted for its high torque ratings, was tested performing real-world tasks at the BMW plant in Spartanburg, South Carolina. BMW is exploring how advanced humanoid robots can be integrated into vehicle production after what the German company calls a successful trial with the Figure 02. In a press release, the luxury automaker noted there are no Figure AI robots in use at the plant and no definitive plans to use them going forward. The robot successfully inserted sheet metal parts during the trial, which BMW said requires considerable dexterity that could not previously be achieved with robots. The German company said there's potential for using humanoid robots for tasks that are difficult, tiring, or unsafe for human workers. The trial was part of BMW's broader iFactory vision for efficient, digitally transformed, and sustainable car production. Earlier this year, Figure announced it had secured $675 million in funding from OpenAI and others. The partnership accelerated the development of the humanoid's conversational abilities. Weeks after the February announcement, Figure released footage of the robot conversing in real time. The robot's AI models were developed in partnership with OpenAI and trained on NVIDIA GPUs, enabling the Figure 02 to interact with people through voice commands. According to NVIDIA's blog, Figure AI accelerated the robot's development using Isaac Sim, a reference application built on the Omniverse platform. The synthetic data was used to design, train, and test the robot. NVIDIA said a second RTX GPU on board makes the robot 3 times better at performing AI tasks on its own compared to the original. If you're wondering how the Figure 02 might do in a battle with Tesla's Optimus humanoid robot, check the link in the description. Two of these humanoid robots worked around the clock for at least 21 days at Zeekr's 5G smart factory. The Chinese electric vehicle manufacturer is testing the UBTECH Walker S Lite humanoid robots for tasks like lifting and carrying materials and assisting in smart manufacturing operations. The Walker S Lite is a lighter, more deployable version of the Walker S that's reportedly been in testing at NIO, another Chinese EV maker. The Lite version handles general manufacturing tasks, while the Walker S is suited for complex tasks like quality inspections and assembly line integration. The Walker S Lite can create 3D semantic maps for navigation. It recognizes and grasps objects with hand-eye coordination. The testing is part of a collaboration between UBTECH, Miracle Automation Engineering, and Zeekr's parent company, Geely Holding. Zeekr, founded in March 2021, specializes in high-tech, luxury electric vehicles. NIO is also testing the first humanoid robot equipped with Huawei's HarmonyOS at the Chinese electric vehicle manufacturer's assembly plant. The robot, named Quavo, is being tested at factories of NIO and Jiangsu Hangtong Group. The humanoid robot developed by Leiju Robotics debuted at Huawei's HDC 2024 developer conference in June. Quavo is designed for industrial and domestic settings. HarmonyOS is an open-source operating system designed to work with a broad range of devices like smartphones, tablets, wearables, smart TVs, and IoT devices. Founded in 2014, NIO is one of China's leading EV manufacturers, focusing on high-performance, premium electric cars. Chinese scientists say they've cracked the challenge of making humanoid robots show realistic facial expressions. They say the two-step process they've devised can improve human-robot interactions in roles like customer service and caregiving. Software teaches the robot to create detailed facial expressions by using action units to isolate emotion-related features. The isolation helps the robot focus on emotions, making its expressions more accurate. The robot's face moves naturally using motor commands to match the expressions. The robot was developed by Professor Liu Xiafeng's team at Hohai University. The findings were presented in the international journal IEEE Transactions on Robotics. NEURA Robotics says its humanoid robot, the 4-in-1, has cognitive abilities. The German company says the robot can see, hear, and even touch.
NEURA released new footage of the 5'11" humanoid robot to coincide with its announcement that it joined NVIDIA's humanoid robot developer program aimed at accelerating robot deployment globally.
The AI robot has sensors for multimodal interaction and 3D vision for recognizing objects and environments. Its force torque sensors give it the sense of touch. The robot also has a touchless human detection sensor. With interchangeable forearms, the 4-in-1 is designed for an array of tasks in industrial and domestic settings. Besides the 4-in-1, NEURA's product lineup includes the Lara series cobots and Maria, which the company calls the first commercially available cognitive robot.
A humanoid robot named Adam is now serving drinks at Walmart in Rockford, Illinois. The AI robot, developed by Richtech Robotics, will serve drinks like coffee and boba tea at the One Kitchen restaurant inside the department store. Beaver's Wealth Universe, which owns the One Kitchen restaurant brand, plans to introduce Adam in 240 ghost kitchens, which are virtual kitchens used for delivery and takeout. The parent company created a new company, AlphaMax Management, to manage the robotic integrations and customer service. Las Vegas-based Richtech also recently deployed Adam to dispense drinks like lemon drops and whiskey sours at the Texas Rangers Globe Life Field. The robot served more than 500 drinks in its first week. The company says Adam makes work easier for stadium employees, especially on busy game days.
This is Berkeley Humanoid, a low-cost mid-sized robot intended for researching learning-based control. The research platform was developed by Berkeley's Hybrid Robotics Research Group. The researchers describe the robot as lightweight and easy to build in-house. It's designed for learning new control methods with simple simulations. Hybrid Robotics says the robot is tough and durable so it can fall repeatedly and continue working. It performs tests outside on different terrains and can move in all directions easily.
The group says the Berkeley Humanoid is great for studying and developing new robotics tech.
Will the U.S. ban the import of Chinese humanoid robots? Jacob Hellberg, who played a major role in convincing Congress to force the sale or ban of TikTok, is urging Congress to act. He's a member of the influential U.S.-China Economic and Security Review Commission. He told the New York Post allowing the sale of robots by firms beholden to Beijing could prove disastrous. The Post reported that support for a potential ban is growing.
Hellberg warns that China's advanced humanoid robots could be used for espionage, surveillance, security breaches, and even physical attacks if allowed into the U.S. market.
He said the tech is advancing mind-bogglingly fast. He predicts the world will become acutely aware of the issue in about a year.
House Majority Leader Steve Scalise has said there's a real and very concerning threat.
However, the Post quotes other experts as saying Hellberg's warning is far-fetched and potentially distracting from more pressing concerns. U.S.-China Commission documents dating back to 2010 cite humanoid robots as an emerging cause for concern. In a 2016 report, the commission rang alarms about how fast China was advancing its AI robots compared to other countries. At that point, China was focused on pushing advanced AI and robotics tech into the future for industrial and military applications.
By 2018, one-third of all the industrial robots installed worldwide will be in China, but that's based from the estimates of the International Federation of Robotics.
There was also increasing emphasis on service robots. The reporting predicted that robots would become more common in daily life, with normalized presence at home, in hospitals, and in factories. They said China would lead in robot development, making smarter and more capable robots that could be manufactured at scale. Critics say the commission often sensationalizes potential threats and oversimplifies China's innovation system. Still, the TikTok legislation made it to President Biden's desk with bipartisan support. So it's very possible a similar ban could become favored as humanoid robots enter the mainstream. China's humanoid robot ambitions are well noted. The country is making serious strides as it aims to mass produce advanced humanoid robots by 2025. Chinese officials and business leaders want to nurture a few large-scale companies and create a cluster of specialized small and medium-sized enterprises. At the 2024 World Artificial Intelligence Conference in Shanghai, China showcased its first full-size general-purpose humanoid robot, Kinglong. The open-source initiative is meant to drive innovation in the Chinese robotics sector. The humanoid robot can navigate different terrains, recognize and interact with objects and people, and manipulate objects with precision. Unitree is also seen as disruptive with its $16,000 G1 humanoid robot, a pint-sized version of its full-scale humanoid, the H1. There's a growing array of Chinese robots gaining global attention.
I am Elektro, mightiest of all robots.
In 1939, Westinghouse Electric Corporation set the standard for humanoid robots with Elektro. Standing 7 feet, Elektro was capable of amazing feats for its time, like walking, moving its arms, turning its head, blowing balloons, and speaking with a 700-word vocabulary. It could even smoke cigarettes.
And folks, he's only 2 years old.
Elektro was powered by motors and controlled by a series of commands. Elektro amazed crowds at the 1939 New York World's Fair. Joining it on stage was Sparko, a robotic dog that could bark, sit, and beg to humans. It's a highlight of the 1939 movie The Middleton Family at the New York World's Fair, produced by Westinghouse. It follows a fictional family as they marvel at the fair's exhibits. The film is now preserved in the Library of Congress as culturally and historically important for capturing the excitement and optimism of the era's technological progress. It wasn't Electro's last movie. After the fair, Electro embarked on a promotional tour, appearing at events, exhibitions, and trade shows. It was featured in the 1960 film Sex Kittens Go to College. In the lighthearted comedy, Electro plays Thinko, a super intelligent robot with human-like traits. It uses its supercomputer capabilities to gamble and win at games of chance. Electro endures as a symbol of early robotic innovation. The robot found its home at the Mansfield Memorial Museum in Ohio, where it remains on display as a significant piece of robotic history.
My name is MenteeBot. How can I help you?
Hey, Mentee. Please take the shopping cart and come with me.
This is MenteeBot, an AI shopping companion in robotic form. Mentee Robotics says a large international retailer suggested deploying robots to push shopping carts for the elderly. The Israeli company says it was also approached by a nursing home chain considering robotics to remedy labor shortages. In response, the team quickly developed a robot that could grab a shopping cart and follow someone in a wheelchair. The robot stops when its shopping companion does and pushes the cart smoothly. The robot is expected to be available to select customers in 2025. Robot success increases by over 67% using digital twins of real-world locations for training. That's according to researchers from the US and Germany, who developed a new method for training robots with computer simulations called Real-to-Sim-to-Real or Rialto. First, the physical location is scanned to create a detailed digital copy. With that, a digital twin is built that reflects the physical space in real time. The robot's software operates in the virtual environment, letting it see and interact with objects as if they were real. Robots practice tasks in the digital twin, safely learning and improving their skills virtually. After training in the simulation, the research team says, the robots perform the tasks in the real world with much greater success. The study used Franca-Amica Panda robotic arms. Tasks performed included stacking dishes and placing books on a shelf. The researchers are affiliated with the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, the University of Washington, and the Technical University of Darmstadt. The study was partly funded by the Sony Research Award Program, the U.S. federal government, and Hyundai.
Hi everyone, my name is Lin Kang. In the past 3 months, I built this humanoid robot, RX1, and now I open source it.
This humanoid robot is open source and can be built for under $1,000. That's according to Lin Kang Jang, founder of Red Rabbit Robotics in British Columbia, Canada. Jang says the RX1 has full human-scale robotic arms, built in stereo vision, and understands the world in three dimensions. It can be trained to complete tasks using simulation software. Researchers from UC San Diego and MIT have developed a new system for controlling robots with VR goggles from far distances. The system, called Open Television, provides an immersive experience. The operator could be as far as 3,000 miles away, as demonstrated by an operator in Boston controlling a robot in San Diego. It mirrors the operator's hand and head movements on the robot, delivering immersive, active visual feedback. The robot sends 3D video back to the operator for better visibility into the robot's surroundings. Using the teleoperation method, robots can perform tasks like sorting cans, folding towels, and moving items. The team tested the system with the Chinese-made humanoid robots, Unitree's H1 and Fourier's GR1. They used Apple Vision Pro and MetaQuest goggles for the experiments. The researchers reported high success rates. The H1 and GR1 had a 92 and 87% success rate for picking up cans, respectively. They had more trouble placing the cans in the correct position, with the H1 a success rate at 88% and the GR1 at 60%. However, they both had a 100% success rate folding towels. In its report, the researchers said operators found it easier to control robots using this system compared to traditional methods. The system's code and setup are open source and available online for anyone to use. Remember to subscribe to stay hip on the latest in humanoid robotics. Leave suggestions for humanoid robots to include in future roundups in the comments.